business registration requirements and where to register my business. Business registration requirements. Registration into the Trade and Personal Property Credit Register, RCCM, Commercial Register. So requirements, registration requirements. We are talking about the commercial register. Register the commerce. Register the commerce. That is the first step that you want to go. Let me show you an example of register the commerce here. I may not be able to show you the rest, but let me show you one. This is for Edwin Enterprise, a company that I run. Since 2014, that is in charge in. So this is a registered commerce or a commercial register. Ceci est comme la carte grise de l'entreprise. So ceci est comme la carte grise de l'entreprise. Lorsqu'on veut être formel, when we want to go formal, you have to go by registering your business, and then you will be given this document. That's what we are going to talk about now. The documents that you have to furnish to the state and the amount in order to obtain this document so that you can be considered as a registered business holder. You can pass it around. You be careful with it, it's fragile. You can see it. Pass it around. So, to obtain a commercial register, you need a copy of your national identity card or birth certificate. Il faut une copie de la carte d'identité nationale ou l'acte de naissance. A copy of your marriage certificate for women, when necessary. Il y a des situations où, lorsque c'est une femme, on lui demande, n'est-ce pas, l'acte de mariage. Mais ce n'est pas dans tous les cas. Localisation plan, proof of address, un plan de localisation, certificate of non-conviction. How do we call it in French again?
L'extrait
de casier judiciaire. L'extrait de casier judiciaire, nous devons préciser ici que pour les francophones, vous devez l'obtenir là où vous êtes né. D'accord? Pour les francophones, si vous n'êtes pas né à Yaoundé, vous devez l'obtenir dans le sens, n'est-ce pas, où vous êtes né. Alors, pour les anglophones, votre part d'extrait de casier judiciaire, your own certificate of non-conviction is called, you know, it's a special certificate of non-conviction number 3. So when you go, you ask for it, it's different from what the francophones get. And where do you get it from? We're going to see it very soon. Lease contract, contrat de bail. You show that your business is located in the premises. And then you need a stamp application, physical stamp, with some registration fee. Registration fee of about 60,000, 64,000. This rate, actually, if you look on the receipt on the registration that I have is 53,000. How much is this there?
53,000.
53,000.
Yes, 53,000.
Yes, 53,000 is the official rate. But when you go to those places, you may have to pay up to 64. We don't know where the rest of the money goes. Then some of those people, that is how they behave. But this is the official rate on the receipt, 53,000. Okay? So don't you get surprised. When you're going out of your house, you should have approximately 70,000 because you're going to buy some forms, buy stamps, and so on and so forth. To have a, you know, commercial register. So That's what we need for. Where to register my business? You register your business in the court of first instance. Le tribunal de première instance. C'est là où on délivre le registre de commerce. N'est-ce pas? Arrivé là-bas, on va vous donner une fiche que vous allez remplir. Et à partir de cette fiche, on va prendre l'information dont on a besoin sur vous. Et puis, c'est cette information qui va figurer sur votre registre de commerce. Et il faut préciser ici que le registre de commerce tient compte de la nature de l'activité que vous menez. N'est-ce pas? Le registre de commerce. Par exemple, en tant que consultant, j'ai un registre de commerce qui démontre que je suis consultant en développement. OK? You have to be specific. Otherwise, you will see commerce général, general commerce, when you are involved in trade, buying and selling. OK? So, before going, you must be able to say exactly what you're going to do. For instance, this one is public contracts. The register of commerce that is circulating is for public contracts. So, as I was introduced, I have experience in the domain of enterprises. That is an enterprise that is in charge of public contracts. I have experience in the domain of development consultancy. That is advanced consulting. That is what I'm doing here now. I have experience in the domain of civil society activities. I am the founder of Robust Cameroon. Robust Cameroon is in charge of carrying out not-for-profit activities. Okay? So, you will understand, therefore, let the digression go. So, you get your registration from the court of first instance and you go to service the press, that is the clerk's office for the court register. Right? La greffe. You know that place? Les greffiers. They are at the court, so you go to their service, that is where you will get information about your registration. And in Yaoundé, you can find the court of first instance au palais de justice. You have it in Ekounou. I don't know whether in Mendon is it the first court of first instance? Yes. So they should be registering businesses too. Mendon just started of recent. So those are places where if you want to register your business, you can go to. Okay, we'll go directly to taxes. We'll go directly to taxes. Just please go back to registration. I want to treat under registration as well a taxpayer's card, la carte de contribuable. Who has heard about a taxpayer's card before? Who has one here? Who? Let me see, show your hand. Okay, do you have it with you? Okay, let me show you a taxpayer's card. Voilà, nous venons de terminer avec la carte grise de l'entreprise, c'est-à-dire le registre de commerce. Maintenant, nous partons du tribunal pour les impôts, n'est-ce pas? La différence entre le tribunal et les impôts, le tribunal dépend du ministère de la Justice. So you are living from the Ministry of Justice to the Ministry of Finance. right? So there are two different departments. And in finance, you're talking about taxes. That is the next stage where we are going to move. So this is an example of a taxpayer's card. Everybody who pays taxes to the government is supposed to have this document. And on that document, you have your name, you have your business name, you have your tax center, and then your sex, your nationality, your date of birth, and some details on your ID card. And then what is so important as well there is tax schedule. The type of taxes you're going to pay, they're also mentioned there, okay? So when you're moving from the informal to the formal sector, you will begin to see this document, you will own them and you will work with them. It has a validity and a cost, we are going to see it. Application for a taxpayer's card. What do I need to do in order to have a taxpayer's card? You can apply for your taxpayer's card at the Cambodian Tax Center. Document to be produced to the tax office are a copy of your national identity card, your registration certificate, that the business registration that I showed you. Okay? If you are an enterprise, you have to produce that registration. Meaning that you're supposed to go in for the registration before you come for your taxpayer's card. Okay? A business location plan and a fee of about 1,000 francs. 1,500 francs. That is the official rate. But for the number of years that I've been paying, when I go to taxation, they amuse me and end up paying 5,000. I'm giving you the official rate and some of the things you will meet on the fee. Okay? So when you go for your first time, the official rate you have to pay for a taxpayer's card is 1,500. But the people turning around, you might end up paying 5,000. Maybe because you don't know, or because you want to be comfortable with that. Okay. We have what we call the patent. You can apply for a patent at the Cameroon Tax Center. Documents to be provided. We will see them later on. And then we have declaration at the CNPS or the National Social Insurance Fund. When you have an enterprise, one of the things you have to do, you have to declare the number of workers you have, the number of workers on your payroll at the National Social Insurance. So we are going to see that also subsequently. You also have to work with the Labor Office. The Labor Office, which is where your business is located,